Hello scrappers, let me show you today how to do reverse electroplating, and it will be silver reverse electroplating. So I have this silver spoon, silver plated. It's quite thick silver plating on it, and how I will remove this silver from this spoon. I can use reverse electroplating. This is my power supply. It's set on 1.8 volts. And I think it's fine. As electrode here, I use stainless steel and distilled water. What is this white chemical? This is sodium sulfate. 50 grams per 1 liter of water. So let me quickly add it. Okay, maybe it needs to be a little bit steering is needed here. I will not use my magnetic steer because sodium sulfate relatively quickly dissolves, almost there. I see only a little bit on the bottom. Here we go. But it will dissolve during the reaction, more or less. It's not critical. And next step is to put inside our silver plated object. Immediately reaction starts. And you maybe see that I have 0.13, 0.14 amps. So what is happening now? We have our silver going into the solution, and our silver, we are removing the silver. We do the opposite of silver plating. That's why we call it silver reverse electroplating. And let me put this silver plated object inside, not shortening the circuit. And as you can see, there are small bubbles coming on the surface and on the surface of the electrode, which means that reaction started. Let's wait 1 or 2 minutes and I'll show you the result, how this spoon will look like after 2 minutes reverse electroplating. Okay guys, so let me show you something. Now I'm working at 1.8 volts and I have 0.10 amps. Of course, you may speed up the reaction. And the easiest way to speed up the reaction is to increase the current. So I'm now going to 3 volts and maybe you see that there are quite many bubbles coming out. Reaction speeds up. Let's have a look at the spoon. You can see what's the difference between the two areas. So let's continue. I can increase the voltage to 5. And maybe you can see, or you're not seeing, but I can tell you that amps went up to 0.9 and it's going to 1 amp now. And the reaction is really quick. Here you go. Let me show you something. If you scratch the surface, you can see that this is the silver that is coming off. Okay, let's keep it at 5 volts and 0.9 amps. So the reaction goes really fast. And usually, this stainless steel electrode, I don't use half electrode. I use it now just for better visibility in this beaker. I usually use electrode that is round, so you have the same speed of reverse electroplating from all sides of this spoon. It will not be dependent on the direction, because now reaction goes between these two electrodes in this direction. If I rotate this spoon, you can see that on the other side looks a little bit different. Its reaction is not going that fast on both sides. But let's keep it a couple of more minutes here and let's see what will happen with this spoon. We are at 5 volts and 1 amp. So it's up to you. You can keep the voltage at about 1.8. So this is optimal, really not quick, but you get really good, pure, good quality silver. Other option is to put it, increase the voltage, increase the current, and then, of course, you see also increase of the amps, it will go up from 10 times. I mean, we increase the voltage from 1.8 to 5, and we went up from 0.1 to 1.1 amps. Let's wait a little bit more. Look at the spoon now. It's such a big difference between the two sides. Let's put it back and let's wait. It's really quick and it's really easy way to process your silver plated forks, spoons, and all types of silver plated kitchen and decorative different types of objects. And the good thing is that you remove the silver and you still can sell the as a brass or up to your buyer rest of the metal, because it's maybe 10-12 of them are 1 kilogram. So you earn from the silver and you earn from the scrap metal. You're not losing anything. And sodium sulfate, it's really easy to find, it's really cheap. You just need some time to sit. A simple power supply that costs 30-40 euro or US dollars perfectly works. Let me try to scratch a little bit the silver surface now. You see, I can scratch it now. So silver is slowly removed from the surface. Let's continue. Let's wait a little bit more. You can do experiment and you can even more increase the voltage. Let's go up to 10 volts, just for the experiment. So we can't go above 7.8. Let me try. We can't go above 7.8. This is the maximum. And if you touch the solution, you see there's so many bubbles. And this is our, you can see the surface, how different it is. This black stuff is the silver. So it goes down. And if you look at the electrode in this area here, you can see that there is silver on the electrode. I'm scratching it on purpose just to show you that silver goes to the electrode. When we are done with the reaction, but in general, reaction is not supposed to go so quick. Reaction is supposed to go slower. Now it's really fast. This is not the way. The way this reaction has to go is we do it for the experiment. You are not supposed to do mistakes. That's why I'm doing this video, to do all the mistakes. We work at 1.8 volts and then the reaction is really slow, goes slowly, but you get good quality silver stripped from the spoon. Let's wait and I'll show you the result in a couple of minutes. Okay guys, I'm not sure if you can see this on the camera, but on the bottom I can see now small pieces of silver that are falling. Look at this. All these small pieces of silver that are falling to the bottom. Let me scratch it a little bit. Here you go. This is our silver coming off the spoon. Well, look at this. So what you have, part of the silver falls to the bottom as small pieces of silver. Some of the silver goes to the electrode, to the stainless steel electrode, and still part of the silver is still on top of the spoon. So just reaction continues. But with reverse electroplating, you should not be in a hurry, because actually if you calculate, or if you check how long it takes to remove the silver from one spoon, you can just leave it for 5 minutes or 10 minutes and do something else. So this is really lazy, really easy way to recover silver, because the cell is working by itself. You have nothing to do. There is no smell, nothing. You see, it's clear water, still some of the sodium sulfate, not dissolved, but it will dissolve. There's no issue. There is enough in the solution for the reaction to go. You can scratch the surface of the spoon. Let me remove this and show you. You can scratch the surface of the spoon. Look at this. And literally, you can wash the silver off. You see how I remove the silver? So that is what is left at the end. All the silver falls. And that's what I said. Because the spoon was facing the electrode like this, all the silver from this side is already removed. But on the other side, you see that some of the silver is not removed, just because the reaction goes with, let's say, quickest from the spoon to the electrode in this direction. Of course, it works on the other side too, but it's not that quick. So I will just rotate it now, like this. Let's don't mess up. This is a really good power supply, actually. If I shorten the circuit, nothing will happen. It will just say, "Pook," and that's all, and will continue working. But I don't want to do this. And you see that silver is floating everywhere inside. Small silver pieces that are falling to the bottom. So it took probably 6-7 minutes so far. I am working at 1.8 volts and 0.18 amps. This is the current voltage and amps, and reaction goes pretty smoothly. In general, it's not good when you have bubbles. I mean, they're small bubbles, but there should not be foam on the top. Because some people are really in a hurry to have this reaction going quickly, and they change the voltage to something like 10 volts, or as many as their power supply allows them. And then they get foam on top of the surface, which is, that's not the purpose. With the reverse electroplating, you're not supposed to be in a hurry. The opposite, reaction goes slowly and you get good quality silver on the bottom and on the electrode. So let's go back to the normal 1.78 volts. You see silver is floating everywhere. So here we go.